In this video, I will talk about how to create a project network. Large projects can be represented by network models. In a project network, each arc represents an activity. The arc is associated with a duration. Each node represents an event. It means the start or the completion of one or more activities. The entire project is completed when all activities have been completed. Let's check some examples. This is a portion of a project network. Activity A starts at node 2 and ends at node 3. It lasts for 5 days. Activity B starts at node 3 and ends at node 4. It lasts for 6 days. Activity A must be completed before activity B can begin. Activity A is called the predecessor of activity B, and activity B is called the successor of activity A. This is the second example. Both activities A and B must be completed before activity C can begin. They are predecessors of activity C, and activity C is the successor of A and B. This is the third example. Activity A must be completed before activities B and C can begin. A is a predecessor of B and C. B and C are successors of A. These project networks are called activity on the arc networks. There is another type of project network called activity on the node networks, which will not be covered in this video. There are some rules we need to follow when building project networks. Rule 1. Always use node 1 to represent the start of the project. If an activity has no predecessors, then it should begin with node 1. Rule 2. We should always use a node to represent the completion of the project in the network. Rule 3. We need to number the nodes in the network so that the node representing the completion of an activity always has a larger number than the node representing the beginning of the activity. Rule 4. An activity should be represented by only one arc in the network. Rule 5. Two nodes should not be connected by more than one arc. To avoid violating these rules, it may be necessary to add a dummy node and a dummy activity that takes zero time and rearrange the node numbers. Let's check this example. It has three nodes and three activities. It violates Rule 5 of the project network because these two nodes are connected by two arcs, A and B. Let's try to modify this figure. We need to add a dummy node and a dummy activity. The dummy activity has a duration of 0. After this modification, node 1 and node 2 are not connected by two arcs anymore. However, this change has violated Rule 3. For the dummy activity, the beginning node 4 is larger than the completion node 2. Let's further modify this figure and renumber the nodes like this. Now there is no violation. Node 1 is the starting node of the project, and node 4 is the end node of the project. With these rules in mind, let's see how to create a project network using available information. This is a house building project. It involves 6 activities. Activity A is recruiting workers. It will take 6 days. Activity B is purchasing construction materials. It will take 9 days. These two activities do not have any predecessors, so they should be connected with the starting node 1. After activities A and B are completed, we can start to build the house frame and install electric wires. They are activities C and D. Their durations are 7 days and 8 days respectively. After we finish building the frame, activity C, we can start to mount the roof, activity E. It takes 10 days. Finally, after the wiring and the roof activities D and E are completed, we can start to clean the construction site and decorate the house. It will take 12 days. This is the initial project network we built. The initial network has violated Rule 5 because we have two arcs connecting nodes 1 and 2. We need to modify the initial network by introducing a dummy node 6 and a dummy activity with a duration of 0. Then we need to renumber the nodes so that the node representing the completion of an activity always has a larger number than the node representing the beginning of the activity. So the node numbers are changed to 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, that is how to create a project network. Thanks for watching.